Hi again. In this video, we'll be using the single objective particle swarm optimization method to solve hostel room allocation problem. This video is made as a part of assignment 2 of Nature Inspired Programming course at IIT Gandhinagar. This is a real life problem faced by hostel administrators. The parameters in the current scenario are: we have 40 rooms out of which 16 are double occupancy. We have 56 students, 28 girls and 28 boys. Each student has a preference rank for the 40 rooms that can be expressed as the following function, which is 11 and onto. Our aim is to allocate rooms such that each student gets a room. The sum of preferences of the rooms allocated to the students is minimum. No student gets a room below a certain preference rank. And girls or boys are not given the same double room. Due to limitations of my computer, we'll be ignoring the last two constraints. We will be trying to assign unique student numbers to the 40 rooms. Since out of the 40 rooms, some are double occupancy ones, two students would be assigned to the same room. For the sake of uniformity, let's break each double occupancy room into two rooms with the same preference rank across all students. But the sequence of students we will be using does not form a vector space because the same student cannot be assigned two rooms. Hence, using this domain for PSO will be a nightmare where vector additions are performed frequently and the probability of getting a valid sequence is almost nil. Therefore, I have redefined the input. We will be using a vector from the shown domain. Here, each x is an integer within the upper and lower limits as shown. The ith student in the sequence of students can be found by selecting and removing the xith student from a shrinking list of initially 56 students. For example, let's consider we had only 5 students in the student list. Thus, the vector has 4 elements within the corresponding upper and lower limits. To generate the student allocation sequence, let us pick the first element in the vector, that is 4. So we will remove the fourth element from the student list, that is 4 again, and add it to the student allocation sequence. Thus, we will be left with only 4 students in the student list. Next, we pick the second element in the vector, that is 1. Again, we remove the first student in the student list, that is 1 again, and append student to the student allocation sequence. Now we are left with 3 more students. We follow this procedure till the last element in the vector. Now we are left with only 1 student in the student list, that is 3. So we add that student, 3, to the end of the student allocation sequence. So each 55 dimensional vector will give me a valid student allocation sequence. However, this might introduce new local minimums in the search space. But we will be using PSO that is specifically used to find the global minimum among a large number of local minimums. This procedure can conveniently be performed using a linked list structure for the student list. Now we apply the particle swarm optimization technique. We have defined our input domain such that each student is guaranteed a room. Using single objective PSO, we will be minimizing the sum of preferences. But can we get an upper bound on the max individual preference? When the PSO is run with the sole objective of minimizing max individual preference, my computer could reach only till 27 after running for 3 hours. Also, the gender constraint could have been handled by introducing higher dimensions to the vector for specifying which double occupancy room is allocated to which gender. But this again would have exponentially increased the runtime on my computer. Now we start the PSO run. We have parallelly started multiple PSO runs. Here you can see the evolving global best values for the different PSO runs. The abscissa value of these points gives the current iteration number. Note that the x-axis is in logarithmic scale. Hence, the speed appears to be decreasing with increasing time. The PSO run that came out with the minimum upper bound on the individual preference number gives the following room allocation. The sum of preferences is close to the median of the 25 runs. This is the PSO run that came out with the minimum sum of preferences. The allocation table is as follows. However, the max individual preference is quite high. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.